Yes! Yes! Fuck you too!
Welcome back to I'm a Fan Reaction Channel. Y'all, it's been a month. My laptop was down and out. I finally got it fixed. I feel so awkward. Like, I feel like it's been so long. I don't know what to do. Let's get started, y'all. I'm so excited. Coming to America. I can't believe I'm probably about to watch this movie. It's so sad. I am so freaking late. Oh my gosh, y'all. Samuel Jackson. Every time I see people play the violin, I get so like warm inside because I used to play the violin when I was younger. So one day I'm gonna pick it back up. Oh, to wake him up. Wow, okay.
Happy birthday, Your Highness.
Yes, it is my birthday.
That accent? Can I just say, Eddie Murphy was in his bag in the 90s. Damn, all these movies. Comedians make the best actors. They really do.
Oh, it is my 21st birthday. Do you think perhaps just once I might use the bathroom by myself?
The royal penis is clean, Your Highness.
Is that Garcelle? I don't know how to say her last name, but she's a housewife nowadays. And that's Garcelle. I mean, she still acts as well. The last thing I saw her in was The Other Black Girl. I guess what it's called, The Other Black Girl. That was a good show.
His Highness must be very...
I feel sorry for the person who has to like walk behind him and clean it up. That's so funny to me. My bad for stopping the movie so fucking much. Y'all have probably already seen this movie, so let me talk, okay?
Are you excited today?
Why is that, O'Hara?
Today is your 21st birthday, which means you meet your wife-to-be.
Well, I'm curious, but how can a man get excited about a woman he's never seen?
Yeah. Long-ass table.
Cooking, the pampering, the dressing, the bathing. Actually, I'd rather enjoy the bathing, but just for once, I would like to cook for myself and take care of myself. And why? Why can't I find my own wife?
Aha! So that's it. We've gone to a great deal of trouble to select for you a very fine wife.
But Father, what if I do not love her?
It is normal to feel anxiety about meeting your queen.
Every time he talks, all I hear is Mufasa. That's the downside of seeing Lion King first before you see this movie. Lion King came after this, like around like 1992, something like that. I don't know. Or 1990. When did Lion King come out? I'm not opposed to arranged marriage. Am I opposed? I'm not really opposed to it. Yeah.
But when I marry, I want the woman to love me for who I am, not because of what I am.
And who are you?
I am a man who has never tied his own shoes before.
I tied my own shoes once. It is an overrated experience.
Good morning, Your Majesty. It is another beautiful day in Zamunda.
And, Simi?
You need to, like, give your child the other experience as well. So he won't take his pampered life for granted. You feel me?
So you say you can have a woman who'll obey your every command. But you'd rather have a woman who has an opinion? Only dogs are to obey. If you truly love your wife, you will value her opinion.
Definitely something.
So you would share your bed and your fortune with a beautiful fool?
That is the way it has always been with men of power. It is tradition.
I am Colonel Izzy. And today, with your blessing, I offer my daughter to your son.
Oh, okay.
Greetings, great prince. Presenting Miss Amani a say.
Thank you, Jesus. Yeah. Oh, they got dancers, okay? Those are dancers. High energy. Ooh, goodness. That was beautiful. Y'all see her waist? She is snatched. Go ahead, girl, whoever that is. She is snatched. Damn. Wow. Wow. Okay, now. She looks exactly the same. Like, wow. What he's singing right now.
For your direction, your queen.
Oh, good casting. Good casting. They look good next to each other. They look really good together.
Am I not all you dreamed I would be?
Oh, you're fine. Beautiful. It's just that if we're going to be married, I thought we should talk to each other, get to know each other.
Ever since I was born, I've been trained to serve you.
Yeah.
Yes, I know this, but I would like to know about you. What do you like to do?
She doesn't know.
Tell me you like.
Yeah.
What kind of music do you like?
Whatever kind of music you like.
Mm-hmm. I remember watching Bridgerton, and the lady who husband died while having sex with him, the old lady with the cane, they basically raised her to be a wife for that certain man. So that's what it's given right here. Like, she was basically brought into this world to be a wife. I can only imagine, like, not knowing nothing, what you want, what you like. You're only here to serve a man. Ooh.
I know what I like. Yeah. And I know you know what I like because you were trained to know what I like. Mm-hmm. But I would like to know what you like. Are you saying that no matter what I tell you to do, you will do?
Yes, Your Highness.
Mm-hmm. Anything I say, you do?
You'll make a bark.
Yes, Your Highness.
Make a bark.
Bark like a dog.
Bruh. Arf, arf, what? How the fuck did I know that? Woof, woof,
woof, woof, woof. Make a noise like an orangutan.
Ah! I see the two of you are getting along.
Please tell her to stop.
Fine girl, isn't she?
Just a random zebra. And random baby elephants.
Hello, Babar. It seems only yesterday I ordered your first diaper changed, and now you're a man who's about to be married.
Not ordered.
She will give you much pleasure, don't you think?
I am not sure if I am ready.
I know we never had to talk about this, but I always assumed that you had sex with your bathers. I know I do.
It's not that, Father. It's just that I'm 21 years old, and I have never left Zamunda. I have yet to experience what the outside world has to offer.
Ah, so you want to sow your royal oats?
No, it's not that.
You're right! Get out, see the world, enjoy your...
Why old niggas always thinking about sex? Even when he saw his soon-to-be wife, it's like, ooh, she obey everything you say. It's over to the freaky side. Like, damn, let him, like... Ain't about only sex with him. Obviously, your son wants mine, too. And how you can't see that? Are you thinking about just sex? Nigga, come on. But that's surprising. You're like that rich and you haven't even left your home country, or like, that kind of sucks. Or at least like a different city. Why you never left? Was it like some dangerous stuff going on? I at least would have thought like him, their family have all that money to at least like travel some other place, you know? It had to be America, but like some other African countries.
Yourself, fulfill every erotic desire. And in 40 days, you will come back and marry your money.
My father.
It is settled.
Dad, only thing about sex.
The wedding will proceed in 40 days. You may go home now. Good night. Oha, prepare the royal baggage. My son is going on a trip.
Going on a trip.
Prepare the royal baggage.
This trip is an excellent idea. 40 days of fornication. Simi. I have something else in mind. Tell no one of this. I intend to find my bride.
Yeah.
What is wrong with the one you have now? I want a woman that's going to arouse my intellect as well as my loins.
Aww.
Where will you find such a woman?
Aww.
In America.
America.
The land is so big. The choice is so infinite. Where shall we go? Los Angeles or New York? Mm-hmm. But where in New York can one find a woman with grace, elegance, taste, and culture? A woman suitable for a king.
Queens.
I do want to do that someday. Just like spin the globe. Point, that's where I'm gonna go someday, you know?
No one here can know I am royalty. You must appear to be no different than the average man.
I will not say a word.
You don't have to say it, baby. Oh, my Lord.
Oh! You dumb fuck! A couple rich fellas like you should be in Manhattan. This ain't the Waldorf, but a palace.
The palace sounds good. Take us there.
No. I want queens. We're not rich. We're ordinary African students.
Whatever you say, pal.
I was gonna say, did they not do research? But they couldn't, because like it was they didn't want to tell anyone what they really was going to go to America for. So they couldn't like really tell people like, hey, you're going to Queens to find my bride. But I feel like they should have had an assistant or a secretary to help plan this shit, because, oh damn, he was very sheltered. So he don't know about poor people like that, I guess. Oh, honey. Oh, my dear.
What does dumb fuck mean?
They should have brought like a... They should have brought like a trusted advisor, assistant, secretary, or somebody like that who did some research and like really... plan this out for them. But that's me being like logical and thinking ahead. They're just happy and young. Aww. Someone may jack them for all their shit. This might happen. That dirty ass place.
Listen. Real Americans.
Pound for pound, Sugar Ray Robinson is the greatest fighter ever lived.
Oh, come on, man. What about Joe Louis?
Oh, my God.
Ron Bummer.
What's his name? What's his name? Cuba Goody Jr. There it is. Lord, my head went blank. Look at him. Anyways, let's go. Let's keep going.
Hey, man. I'm just saying, I stopped liking Cash Clay. What's his name? Muhammad Ali. What's that shit today?
Wait a second. Wait a second. A man has a...
Is Eddie Murphy playing him too, or is that a real person? It looks like Eddie Murphy. It looks like a mask on him. So is that a real person? I don't think it's a real person.
God damn it, this is a free country. You should respect his wishes and call the man Muhammad Ali.
His mama named Clay. I'm gonna call him Clay.
Mm-hmm. That's right. That's what that
I
comes
say
from.
Clay.
Okay, that's what that comes from.
That's right.
If I'm gonna name Clay, I'm gonna name Clay.
Okay, now what the fuck do you want?
We desire a room.
I mean, he had education, right? Because I'm thinking he should at least know what poor means. Like, poor is not good. He's about to get scammed. Push play. Goodness, play.
Only one bathroom on this floor, so you're gonna have to share it.
Oh, honey.
A little bit of an insect problem, but you boys from Africa, you're used to that. We will take the room. Yes.
I blame the parents. How does he not know what dirty looks like, what poor is? Oh, he's gonna get a rash. Living in that place, gonna get a rash. Ew.
Good morning, my neighbors!
Hey, fuck you!
complete idiot.
Oh, do not be ridiculous.
Just let it shine through. Just let yourself.
Someone tell me, like, was commercials really like that back in the day? Like, very like that? Was commercials really like that back in the day?
Perhaps I should cut off my prince's luck.
No.
Yes.
Oh, there it go. There they go. Every time I start talking about boxing, a white man got to pull Rocky Marciano out their ass. That's they won. That's they won. But compared to Joe Louis, Rocky Marciano ain't shit.
He beat Joe Louis's ass.
Joe Louis was 75 years old when he fought.
I don't know how old he was, but he got an ass whooped.
Joe Louis had come out of retirement to fight Rocky Marciano. The man was 76 years old. He lied about his age all the time. One time, Frank Sinatra comes out here and sat down in this chair. I said, Frank, you hang out with Joe Louis. Just between me and you, how old is Joe Louis? You know what Frank told me? He said, hey, Joe Louis 137 years old. 137 years old.
Oh, man, you ain't never meet no Frank Sinatra.
Well, shit, what kind of chemical you got in there?
I ain't put no chemicals. Only juices and berries.
Shit, that ain't nothing but ultra firm. Tell me how you want me to cut this. That'll be $8.
$8 for that?
How do I look?
The same.
I think it is time to find your queen.
So dramatic.
I've got a secret. I worship the devil.
Find a man that can satisfy me. Got to put in overtime for me to get off.
I'm not interested in a man unless he drives a BMW.
Yeah, well, you know, baby, I'm almost single. My husband's on death row.
This is the first date Teresa and I have been on since the doctor separated us.
Okay. My name is Jesus, and I'm the best all the DJs want to feel my breath.
Sir, we can one go to find nice women here.
Oh, you got to get out and look. They ain't gonna just fall in your lap. Black Awareness Rally, it's gonna be some fine women there. Good, clean girl. That's where I'm going, shit.
Apparently, these are the best women Queens has to offer. Pick one and let's go home. Be patient, my friend.
Exactly.
It feels so lovely to be here tonight. What a beautiful love. Give yourselves a round of applause. You're so lovely. Everyone's
lovely. Eddie as well?
And, thank you. Teach them well and let them lead the way. Show them all the beauty they possess inside.
Not this Prince knockoff.
Give them a sense.
We need to rebuild Linkin Park. We're happy to get the kind of money that jingles, but we'd rather get the kind that folds.
It's me, Dallas. No change, no coins.
Donations. I thought it was a trash. Don't be hitting on me. Some money in this ass. I whoop your ass, class. Don't call me now.
Thank you.
Wonderful.
A kid.
You can see, Lisa, Mr. McDowell and McDowell Restaurant.
Not McDonald's, y'all. McDowell's. Oh, okay.
See, they're McDonald's. I'm McDowell's. Huh? They got the golden arches. Mine is the golden arcs. They use a sesame seed bun.
Damn.
My buns have no seeds. I got it.
Complete difference. No seeds on the bun. That's so cute. Oh my gosh. I just like how like enthusiastic he is. Ooh, my butt hurt. Oh, shoot. Oh. The stool. Yeah, I just like how, like, enthusiastic he is and, like, happy to be there and good for him. Good for him.
Hello.
Hi.
I like how normal she looks. She doesn't look like a superstar or anything like that. She looks like very normal. I like that. Good casting.
Well, when it fills up, don't be afraid to call me. I'll come take it out most urgently.
That's good to know.
When you think of garbage, think of Akeem.
The Jeremy curls back then, y'all. Lord.
Daryl!
I think my mom had one too. Yeah, my mom had a Jeremy curl too. Lord, y'all. Y'all always really out there dripping. Y'all was out there dripping? Oh, man.
Hey, you're looking sharp, kid.
So, how's everything over at Soul Glow?
Fine. You know, our home weave products are really taking off.
Good.
By the way, Dad isn't using the company tickets to the Jets game, and I thought you might enjoy them.
Well, Daryl, that's very considerate of you. Thank you.
Listen, I want to ask you something. The other day at the rally, somebody stuffed a large amount of cash into one of the collection boxes. You wouldn't happen to know who that was, would you?
Well, I,
I thought it was you!
Aw, she's adorable.
You know me. Anything for the kids. Oh, before I forget, I got us 4 tickets to the St. John's game. Maybe your sister want to bring somebody.
Great.
Hey, take care of this for me, will you?
Damn.
Excuse me.
Hey, it's Kunta Kinte!
What can I do with you, boy?
No.
Can you make my hair look like this?
Man, what you want to make your hair look like that for?
Exactly.
Well, I like the way hey, wear natural. That's good, man. You know, I wish more of the young children today would wear their hair natural. I ain't never heard no woman giving no man no love just because his hair look good.
That's right.
Is this American Girl?
Yes.
You got to go through a papa. See, that's a big misconception. People don't know that about American women. Ain't got nothing to do with your hair or your pocket. You get in good with American woman's father, you in good with her. Ain't that right?
He ain't lying.
That's right. You get in good with the father, you won't free.
I was wondering, did you happen to catch the professional football contest on television last night?
No, I didn't.
And in the end, the Giants triumphed by kicking an oblong ball made of pigskin through a big H. It was a most ripping victory.
Son, I'm just gonna tell you this one time.
Yes, sir.
You wanna keep working here, stay off the drugs.
Yes, sir.
Aww.
I don't know how it is in Africa, but here, rich guys get all the chicks.
Yes, he must work very hard.
The Prince of Soul Glow work hard? No way. He lives off his father's invention. He could buy her anything he wants. How are you going to compete with that?
Wow. Think they're real?
Nobody's messing around.
I am not. I don't care how much a man admires you. He's not going to give you earrings like that unless you're giving him a little booty. Not everybody thinks like you, Patrice.
Exactly.
Yes, they do. They just don't admit it.
See, this is why I'm usually eating or doing my hair. If not, I'm going to be on my phone responding back to people. So, like, next time y'all see me, I'm going to be doing my hair. Because I can't... The boring part sometimes, I just want to go on my phone.
Tell her you sent her the $500,000 pair of earrings, then she will fall into your arms and we can leave this godforsaken place.
No, I cannot do that.
Do something.
Do not worry, I have a plan.
What are you going to do, mop your way into her heart?
That is not fair.
This is my sister, Patrice.
Hello, how are you?
Hi. Akeem's from Africa. What you doing in New York?
I'm a student.
What school are you going to?
The University of the United States.
I never heard of that.
Well, it's a very small university. We do not even have a basketball team.
Really? We got an extra ticket for the St. John's game tomorrow. Wanna come?
Wow.
Yes.
Good. You can double date with me and Daryl.
Oh, fuck.
Must be a new experience for me.
Are you able to follow the game, Akeem?
Oh, yes! I'm following the game quite well.
What kind of games are y'all playing after?
Chase the monkey.
No, we play football. I believe you call it soccer.
Yeah, right. You know, personally, I don't like any sport where you don't use your hands.
I don't know why he's dissing soccer like that. That's a really hard sport. All that fucking running. God damn, Bonnie. Chill, Bonnie. All that running, that stamina you need to have for soccer, that's a really hard sport.
Greetings, Your Highness.
Please stop bowing, please.
I am a loyal citizen of Zamunda.
Yes, but you're going to spill your beverages.
This is the greatest day of my life.
Yes,
it was very nice meeting you two. Excuse me.
Wow, that's dope.
Please, okay,
may I just have my picture taken with you?
I will cherish this experience for the rest of my life.
Who was that?
Just the man I met in the restroom.
I wouldn't say that.
Ooh. Sweetheart, why don't you quit this job?
Because I like it here.
My lady doesn't have to work. I'll take care of you. I'll get you anything you want. What can I get you?
Nothing. You know, you're a very unusual guy. I've never seen anybody take so much pride in mopping a floor.
He who would learn to fly one day must first learn to stand and walk. One cannot fly into flying.
Everybody shut up and do what I say! Get the money out! Stay cool! Nobody gets hurt! Take the money!
At first, I was excited to see Samuel Jackson in this movie. He's a rapper. Damn. I guess his earlier films, he played gangster a lot. Kind of on School Days, he played like collared, bum, dropout type of dude. But damn, Samuel.
Money out! All of it! Don't stall me, fat boy. Let's go! Come on! I'm wasting my time now. Come on!
Oh yeah, come on. He's like trained.
Don't stall me! All of it!
Freeze, you diseased rhinoceros pizzle.
Gotta tell you, I'm real proud of the job you did in there today. You know, we've been hit by that guy 5 times. But I got a feeling he won't be coming back. Thanks to my African connection. Say, leave Sunday night open. I'm having a little get-together at my house.
Oh, good.
You see? It is working. He has accepted us as equals.
Oh,
okay, fellas. Just give him a ticket. Take the keys. Park the cars down the street. When you get finished, come inside and help out in the kitchen. Akeem, I want you to come with me. I want to show you the inside of McDowell's little castle.
Okay.
I can appreciate the way you handled that dude with the gun. I would have helped you out myself, except... Well, I had a cup of coffee in my hand, you understand, right? I bet you learned all that stuff fighting lions and tigers and shit.
That's a racist motherfucker.
Yes. Yes, where I'm from, we have to be very aggressive.
Is it xenophobia or something like that?
Especially with women. But they all want a man to take charge. Tell them what to do.
If you learn your girl... Obviously, he did not learn his girl. Because his girl is not the I want you to take charge type of girl. Like, honey. I bet he doesn't even please her in bed. That's how it's giving off. He can't please her. That's what's going on.
Make sure everybody's glass is kept full. We're about to make a very special announcement.
Yes, sir.
Please not engage
me. No. Mr. and Mrs. Jenks, would you please join me? And Mother Jenks, you come up here too.
Damn. Oh, the jury girl.
Daryl here popped the big question. And Lisa happily accepted.
Oh.
So as it turns out, this has become an engagement party. Huh?
How are you going to accept the ring for your daughter? At least do a proper proposal to the daughter. Like, learn your fucking daughter, learn your fucking girlfriend.
Next time you and my father decide to get together to plan my life, I wish you'd let me in on it.
It's not like...
Don't touch me.
But baby, it's our engagement party.
least propose to her the proper way. Damn.
I'm fine. I'm just not going to be pressured into marriage. Not by Daryl, or my father, or anybody.
I understand completely. In my country, they arrange many marriages, and I don't feel anyone should get married out of obligation.
You're right. I mean, how could I have even considered marrying a guy like Daryl?
I wanted the same thing.
He just made me so furious back there. You don't think I overreacted, do you?
The first reaction is usually the correct one.
You know, you're very easy to talk to. I feel like I could tell you anything.
You must be tired of hearing about my problems with Daryl.
Oh, no, not at all.
You know, I feel like I owe you a favor. Why don't you come to my house and I'll fix you dinner? Patrice will be there.
Let us go to my house.
Why?
Well, I'd like to cook for you.
I really like her beanie. That is so cute. It's simple, but just so freaking cute. I really like her beanie.
What's wrong?
Nothing's wrong. Everything's fine. Excuse me for a moment, please.
You told me to fix up the place.
I should kill you.
Why?
It's supposed to be a poor man.
Hakeem?
I am very sorry.
Can we go in now?
Oh, no, we cannot.
Why not?
There is a rat.
I think there is no rat. I think you're just so ashamed of your apartment, you can't even let me see it.
Once again, you have judged correctly.
If it bothers you that much, we can go out to eat.
I really want to do that. I really want to go to New York and just like walk along that side bridge thing. That looks so romantic and simple and peaceful. I don't know if it's going to be peaceful because probably a lot of people might be out there. But that is so romantic. Just walk along and talk, you know?
No, it's not right. I should pay.
Hakeem, we should stop worrying about being poor. If I wanted a wealthy guy, I'd be with Daryl. Not you. What about Patrice?
I am not interested in Patrice.
What about Daryl?
I am not interested in Daryl either.
Yeah.
Sire. Hakeem and I have depleted our funds. Kindly send 300,000 American dollars immediately, as we are in dire straits.
Should I make it 400,000?
You think that'd be enough?
You are right. 500,000.
Oh my God.
As long as you're asking, why don't we go for a cool million?
Okay, what's going on?
Patrice.
You're breaking in.
I came to see Hakeem. What are you two involved in? You can't afford all this stuff on your salary.
To be loved! To be loved! Wow, what a feeling!
I'm happy
to
for
you. To be loved!
Yes! Yes! Simp that hard for me, yes! Be excited, be in love! Oh shit, Lord. Oh, I'm so happy for him.
Sammy, I just had the most wonderful.
Patrice, oh,
hi, Hakeem. Sorry things didn't work out between you and me, but girl, you understand.
He was not interested.
If you're the prince, then who am I?
My servant?
Where you going?
To a museum with Hakeem.
No, I don't like that. I don't like that one bit.
You only like Daryl because he's rich.
Mm-hmm. Lisa, I just don't want you to have to struggle the way your mother and I did. I'll tell you what. I'm gonna let you boys stay in my apartment, and I'll move up here.
Does your apartment look poor?
Yeah, it's a real shithole. You'll love it.
Name, whatever. Is this the song that they were playing? Is that the Bumblebee song? I heard this beat before that. Like, it wasn't drumline. Anyways, let's continue. My bad, y'all. That's drumline. It had to be a drumline. Yeah.
I have come for my son, Akeem.
Come for who?
You know, Kunta from up. Kunta.
Oh, yeah, the boy upstairs. Hey! Hey, who gonna clean up all these flowers?
Exactly.
What is this? Photograph.
What is this? McDowell's.
It's a place over on Queens Boulevard. I think he works there.
My son works.
He moved downstairs. Apartment 1A.
Exactly.
Your Majesty. What are you doing here?
I received your telegram.
Exactly.
What is Akeem?
You asked for $1 million. This is back in the 1980s. I would fly my ass down there too. See, what the fuck y'all doing, okay?
Was to look after Akeem. How could you let him come to such a pass?
Akeem will not listen to me. He's gone quite mad, Your Majesty.
You have disgraced yourself, and you must be punished. Will confine yourself to our royal suite at the Waldorf Astoria. And see that he puts on some decent attire. And I want you to bathe him thoroughly.
That's a punishment?
Oh, thank you, Your Majesty.
Yes.
Look, Zamunda. That's where you're from, isn't it?
Yes. People are very friendly. And you, you they would treat like a queen. Then let them see.
Oh, okay, Lisa, that's why.
Let us go.
This is King Jaffe Jofer, ruler of Zamunda. He is searching for his son, Akeem.
Your son?
Yes, my son, the prince.
Prince? Are you serious?
Prince Akeem is the sole heir to the throne of Zamunda.
I always knew there was something special about that boy.
Can you tell us where he might be?
Oh, yes, he's out with my lovely daughter, Lisa.
I can only imagine how this movie made everyone think that if they met someone from Africa, they were a prince or a princess. Like, I can definitely see girls like, "Oh, you're from Africa? Oh, you're a prince?" I can definitely see it back then. They thought every African nigga they came across, they were a prince. I can definitely see that shit.
Who's here? Akeem, it's good to see you.
It's good to see you too, sir.
Come on inside, have a little drink.
Well, I have to get going, Mr. McDowell.
Oh, no, now you got time for one drink. Have a seat. Yeah, King, both the kids are here, together. Excuse me, I'll be right back.
That was fast. What was that, Daryl? Damn.
Well, who was that?
The dad, he leveled up.
Jehovah's Witness. Excuse me. I warned you, didn't I? Donnie, get him!
Good news, Akeem. We've been rescued.
Rescued?
Where are my parents? They've gone to the McDowell's house to look for you.
Where is Akeem?
He just stepped out. Probably went for a pizza. Hey, you know these youngsters. I don't know whether to shake your hand or kiss it or bow or what. I feel like breakdancing. Come in, have a seat, take a load off.
The royalty, just be respectful, that's it. Don't do too much. They are just people with a higher paying job than you. Or they inherited a lot. They're just people, honey. Ain't that serious. We're all gonna die someday. Daddy will chill out, but it ain't that serious.
This is our king's father, the king.
Leave us. Then he must have told you about his wife in Zamunda.
He's married?
No, but he will be soon. He could not be at all serious about you. Akeem came to America to sow his royal oats.
No, he did not.
Excuse me, I need to be alone for a moment.
What'd you say to my daughter?
I told her the truth, that Akeem could not be interested in her.
How can you be so sure?
Oh, come now. Our son cannot consort with such a girl.
Hey, now, wait a minute.
I know you have been inconvenienced, and I'm prepared to compensate you.
You haven't got enough money to buy my daughter off.
Nonsense.
Joffrey, apologize to Mr. McDowell.
I will do no such thing. The man is beneath me, and so is his daughter.
I don't give a damn who you are. This is America, Jack. Now, you say one more word about Lisa here, and I'm gonna break my foot off in your royal ass.
Why are you hugging him? He's just the servant. He's the prince.
Who told you that?
He just wore his mask. Don't believe
him. You mean Akeem's the prince?
Yeah, and he's in love with Lisa.
How come she always gets the good ones? Dad, what happened?
Lisa dumped me.
Oh, I know. Poor thing.
I know.
First thing we have to do is get you out of these wet clothes.
This sister's foul.
Stop.
Oh, well. Okay, why is she running? Why is she running? Just talk to the man. Damn.
Well, at least I know who gave me these. Well, you can keep them, because I don't want them. And I don't want you.
So dramatic. Oh, went to New York before, and I don't remember the subways being that graffitied up like that. They must have really like cleaned down the subways back then, because I don't remember the subways being so like graffitied everywhere. Yeah, the 90s, late 80s were a different time.
Lisa.
Very
Lisa,
grunge.
Just leave me alone.
I love you.
What about the woman you're supposed to marry?
I do not love her. Why do you think I came to America?
Oh, your father told me to sow your royal oats.
Oh, I came to America to find my bride. I came to Queens to find you.
So why did you lie to me then? Why didn't you just tell me you were prince?
Because I wanted you to love me for who I am.
Mm-hmm. You're royalty, for God's sake.
You want me to renounce my throne? I will.
From this moment on, I renounce my throne. I am no longer the Prince of Zamunda. I renounce my throne!
Girl.
All I care about is you. Marry me, Liz.
Look, I'm sorry, I can't. Goodbye, Akeem.
I feel like he needs to take her to his world to see if they can really mesh, and then she'll be like all in. Because right now it's like, I don't even know how you even operate your day-to-day life. Like, how would it even be like me being your queen, you know? So I feel like once she sees what goes on and like how she will still be herself, I think then she'll be all in. We'll see. I just know with me, I would have to go to your country to see like, okay, so like what would I be doing? How does this work? How does that work? The traditions, the customs, and then still be able to like, can I still do what I want to do? You know, I really like see how can we really blend our lives and then marriage.
It is out of our hands. The girl told him no.
Well, after the way you treated her, who could blame her?
Even if she said yes, they still could not marry. It is against the tradition.
Well, it is a stupid tradition.
Oh?
Who am I to change it?
I thought you were the king.
I must say you're the king. I finally saw Coming to America. Oh my gosh, it took 27 years. It just took 27 years. I finally saw Coming to America. What do I think about it? I like that it wasn't so heavy, just like lighthearted fun, some funny moments. Ooh, the accents. Ooh, honey, child. Ooh, child, accents, honey. Other than that, I wish they would have showed his, like, speech to her after she left him in the train station. Because I think she just showed up at the wedding in a pink, ugly wedding dress. But I wish they would have showed, like, how did she change her mind, you know? People really hype this movie up. People love this movie. I don't love it. Don't hate it. It's good. It was cute. That's how I feel about it. It's cute. It's good. Adorable. I love how enthusiastic he was. Just, like, open to new opportunities. I love that type of energy. Just, like, let's go. Let's do it. Maybe because he was 21, that young spirit of exploring and being curious, you know, I love that type of spirit. So that was really nice to see. I'm glad I finally watched it. But thank you guys for watching. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see y'all next time. We're back, baby. We are back, okay?